Hey, Measuring Hero, Jay here. One of the most important steps of machine qualification is this, the machine qualification tool. Today, I thought we would visit our facility here in Aalen to go through the process that it takes to create this, the machine qualification tool. Okay, so to start us on our journey, I thought we would talk to Helena, who is the product manager of machine equipment. Helena, thank you for tackling this with us. Can you begin us on our journey of making a good qualification tool?
Yeah, Jay, thank you for being here. A warm welcome. For sure, when it comes to qualification tools, we start with design. That's what matters first. But what does it mean? Actually, both parts look similar.
Right.
But actually, it's not the same. What matters is how we design this especially tailor-made for our machines. Mm-hmm. The first step is really to have an idea and to test it on the machine, the ideas which you receive from the customer, the feedback from the application managers, for example. And then you let the ideas go into the development process. And there we found, for example, out that the gluing, which you really cannot see here, mm-hmm. really matters.
So if I hear you correctly, the first step to making a really good qualification tool is a tool that is designed for the machine, that
exactly.
is made for that specific machine, whether it's a VAST or a XXT, we have to make it specifically for it, and you can't really copy it because you don't know the design intent that's
yeah.
around it, right?
Yeah, you have to pay attention mm-hmm. on the whole system.
Sure.
You have to pay attention on the qualification tool which you use for each measurement,
mm-hmm.
and you have to rely on this results and the interfaces between
right.
the CMM and your workpiece, they matter
sure.
because
sure.
that's what you want to rely on.
Got it.
Yeah.
So design matters. Makes sense. What's the next part of the process then?
Yeah, for sure. When it comes to quality, also the production matters.
Mm-hmm.
So quality and production, that's what I will show you now.
Perfect, perfect. So what's the first step? Let's take that one, for example. What's the first step there?
Yeah, for example, our VAST X60 adapter plates. We received the material, we put it on the machine, and we cut our material into the form.
Okay.
And take it to the gluing room.
Perfect, yeah. Okay. Let's go there. Okay, Helena, so we have a raw casting, I guess, if you will, or the raw material. Now what do we do?
Yeah, first of all, we have to clean it up.
Sure.
After we clean it, we get this right here and put hand by hand each ball on its position. And it is done, really, each one hand by hand.
By hand.
Yes,
wow.
Each one. Yeah.
So what I'm hearing is, by hand, you put all of the contact balls in,
yes.
and then flip it over and put the through your process.
Yes, that's what is done here, and also the position is get checked here.
They check the position here, right? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's
very
it.
Very cool.
So now, the ID chip, and when we are talking about the ID chip. That's the part where we are talking about the gluing, which I introduced you.
Oh, yeah.
You remember? Yes, we found out that gluing really matters, and that's the reason why we make up our own glue. So this means we have three different glue sorts,
okay.
and we mix them up here at our site. There are different components which fits best. In order to guarantee that the ID chip, which is here covered mm-hmm. by the magnets, fits well and sits well. So that's also the reason why you really cannot just copy it.
So let me get this straight. You have done research on these adapter plates to the level that you understood that off-the-shelf glue won't work, so you actually went to the level of mixing your own glue
yes.
so that these adapter plates work perfectly?
Exactly.
That's crazy. Yeah.
Wow. So we can rely on yep. what we are selling.
Wow.
All right, so let's get to the checking. The first step of checking, we will check the parallelism in the Z-axis. So what Kai is doing, he's choosing 3 points on the adapter here mm-hmm. and checking each point, whether it is parallel to the adapter plate itself. So we check the parallelism also on each adapter plate right here.
Wow, wow. So everyone by hand not only gets assembled, but checked.
Let's dive in into the details. What is done here? Take a guess, we keep on checking. And this happens here under the microscope. So what Kai is doing here now, he is just checking the whole adapter plate for glue residue mm-hmm. and also, for example, for some minor damages which you cannot see with your eyes. If he finds anything, he just corrects it right away. And at this part, as the same procedure, each one is checked by hand.
By hand, not only made by hand, checked by hand, and then checked again by hand.
By hand, yes. Wow. And we are not done yet.
There's more.
Yeah.
Let's go see.
Coming to the final steps. What we do here, we put on some corrosion protection, mm-hmm. and Patricia is adding the markers, the red dots here, which mean that this is a reference adapter plate.
Got it.
Afterwards, we label our chip, mm-hmm. and then we're done.
Wow, okay, so it sounds like in the end, when you make a like a reference plate or for a reference tool, you spend a lot of time in design, of course, but in hand manufacturing, checking, and checking again, and checking again, all by hand by master craftspeople. To make these perfect reference tools so that we can qualify equipment, right? That's really mind-blowing.
Yeah, but let me tell you something. It's not only for our qualification process of the CMM and our service guys.
Yeah.
It's for each customer, so.
You mean, okay. Wait. You mean to tell me the process that we just went through isn't just for reference tools, it's actually for all accessories?
Totally.
Wow, that's crazy. That is so much work that gets put in there.
Yes, totally.
I think you can really see the quality when it comes
you
to
do.
That.
Absolutely.
Helena,
yes.
Thank you for showing this to me. I need to digest this. For you out there, thank you for joining me. I think I have to rest because that was a mind-blowing piece of information. So I'm gonna end it here. Thank you for joining us. Please continue to stay safe and stay healthy. We'll see you next Thursday.